Good morning. I'm Dr. David Stout, the proud president of Brookdale Community College. Before we begin, I ask everyone to join us in the recitation of the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. On behalf of the entire Brookdale College community, we gather today to celebrate the achievements of Brookdale's 51st graduating class at this 2021 commencement celebration. Your accomplishments reflect your hard work, your perseverance, and dedication to achieving your goals. The higher education journey is never easy under normal circumstances, but the unprecedented challenges we have all faced this year have made it even more difficult, making your achievements even more impressive. You didn't let anything stop you. You persevered and completed your associate's degree despite all the challenges thrown at you. You have proven that you can succeed in the most trying of circumstances. When you began your journey at Brookdale, you could not have foreseen that a deadly virus would upend your life, not to mention the pursuit of your college degree. Every single one of you was affected profoundly by this pandemic. Many of you lost your jobs. Some of you lost loved ones. In their honor and in their memory of more than 586,000 Americans and many, many more around the world, please let us pause for a moment of silence. Thank you. Despite numerous challenges, changes in routines, and profound loss, you persisted on the path to attain your goal. It is the credit to your character and your determination that you have made it to the finish line today. Congratulations on your graduation, and I can't wait to see the amazing things that you will accomplish next. This year, 1,645 students will earn their degrees and certificates from Brookdale Community College. This class includes 24 veterans of the United States Armed Forces. Congratulations and thank you for your service to our country. This class of 2021 also includes 481 students who are graduating with various honors and distinctions, including 285 distinguished scholars, 160 members of Brookdale's Alpha Pi Theta chapter of the Phi Theta Kappa International Honor Society, 91 members of the National Society of Leadership and Success, and 8 NASA STEM Fellows. The 7th cohort of NASA STEM Fellows includes Antoinette White, Bobby Kays, Gary Roberts, Megan O'Hare, Nora Thompson, Julio Santiago Reyes, Dorothy Spears, and Ashley Castillo Gutierrez. The graduating class of 2021 also includes 28 international students from 17 countries around the world. And while study abroad has been on hold since the summer of 2020, we do have graduating students who studied abroad in England and Scotland prior to the pandemic. I also want to acknowledge the graduates of our early college high school programs. These students have earned their high school diplomas and their associate's degrees simultaneously. Congratulations to our graduates from the early college high school programs at Neptune High School, St. John Vianney, Raritan High School, Asbury Park High School, and Wall High School. Today, we also welcome and honor the inaugural class of early college high school graduates from Middletown North and South High Schools, Keyport High School, and Manasquan High School. Congratulations and welcome to the Brookdale family. We at Brookdale are proud to play such a significant role in your success. We are proud to provide educational pathways that can help you to get there from here, wherever your there is. We're proud to be ranked in the top 3% of all community colleges in the United States. This is the result of investing heavily in the best faculty and staff from the best colleges in the region and in the country, However, this would not be possible if it were not for the incredible support of our county commissioners and our Board of Trustees. I would like to acknowledge members of the County Board of County Commissioners. Our commissioners are strong supporters of Brookdale's mission and play a pivotal role in our student success. Thank you to Commissioner Director Tom Arnone, Deputy Director Sue Kiley, Brookdale's Commissioner Liaison Lillian Burry, and Commissioners Nick DiRocco and Ross LaCitra. Commissioner Director Arnone, please step forward to say a few words.
Good morning, family, friends, administration, faculty, and most importantly, graduates. Today is a very special day. It's very special for all of us here in Monmouth County. My fellow commissioners, Deputy Director Sue Kiley, Freeholder Lillian Berry, Freeholder Nick DiRocco, Ross LaCitra. You know, I guess people don't realize as much the importance and how special you, the graduates, are to the commissioners. And that's why we try day in and day out to be able to provide all the resources we possibly can to make your environment here at Brookdale as pleasant as the administration hands over and forwards over to you. But, you know, this is a little special if you think about it. Each and every one of you sitting in these chairs here that have come through, it's a different type of graduation. And the graduation is probably more geared to, we know your resiliency, because you proved that for the last 2 years. Because probably, and I'm hoping, never in the history of Brookdale Community College or for the commissioners, they had to deal with a pandemic. But more importantly, you had to deal with a pandemic. And you had to be able to structure your life, your commitment, your safety, and your education all in one for 2 years. And you did it well. So as a resident of Monmouth County, putting that commissioner hat away, knowing where the future of Monmouth County is, it's bright. It's bright because people like yourself, individuals like yourself, know that they can face the challenges. You face the challenges. Now you have to go out into the world, move on to another part of an education, whatever your venture is. I know that Monmouth County knows that we're in good hands. I want each and every one of you to always stay safe, always stay committed, always be goal-driven, and continue the practice that you've had here at Brookdale, because this was a successful tenure you had here, and Monmouth County thanks you. Congratulations.
Thank you, Commissioner Director Arnone. Commissioner Burry, please step forward to say a few words.
Congratulations to the Brookdale Community College graduating class of 2021. I'm so proud of all your accomplishments, and I'm thrilled to have this opportunity to celebrate those accomplishments. This has not been an easy year for any of us, but you have proven your ability to succeed in the face of a challenge. You continued and excelled in your educational journey while your educational experience pivoted overnight. All classes switched to virtual instruction, and even if you began the semester with online classes, you still had to adjust to all the support and services changing to a virtual setting. But you did not let that stop you from achieving your goals. Your perseverance proves you will succeed in whatever you decide to do next. Graduating from Brookdale is an amazing accomplishment and a proven sturdy foundation for whatever you want to accomplish next. My granddaughter, Stephanie, is a fellow graduate of Brookdale. So then she decided she went on to study at Monmouth University. She is now VP of a successful company. And Stephanie contributes much of her success to the learning environment she received here at Brookdale. Brookdale graduates accomplish amazing things. So once again, congratulations, graduating class of 2021. Your perseverance and ability to adapt and achieve are major accomplishments you should all be very proud of. And I can't wait to see where you go from here and what else you can attain. Thank you.
Thank you, Commissioner Burry. I'd like to thank the members of Brookdale's Board of Trustees for their tireless, dedicated service to our institution and our students. The members of the Brookdale Board of Trustees include Chairman of the Board, Dr. Henry Cram, Vice Chair, Mr. Brett Kaufman, and Trustees Ms. Tracy Abbey White, Ms. LaTanya Brennan, Ms. Suzanne Brennan, Mr. Paul Krupe, Ms. Dais Davis, Ms. Madeline Ferrero, Ms. Barbara Hall, Ms. Marta Rombod, Dr. Lester Richens, and Graduate Trustee, Ms. Hannah Walker of the Class of 2020. I would also like to acknowledge the following individuals. Lauren Concar, President of the Alumni Association. Bernadette Macko, President of the Brookdale Foundation. Chaz Salvatore Bono, 2021 Honorary Degree Recipient. Christina Henderson of the Class of 2014 and 2021 Distinguished Alumna. Barton Henderson, 2021 Distinguished Alumnus. Bruce Marich, Grand Marshal, and Professor Jack Ryan, Grand Marshal. Grand Marshals, please step forward to say a few words.
Congratulations. Today I wear the regalia of the Associate of Arts because, like you, I also am a Brookdale graduate. You have gone through such a quest to get here and to get today's diploma, and your life will be filled with quests just like this. This was the first time that I felt that I did something on my own. I had a tremendous amount of help along the way, but it was my responsibility to get to class, my responsibility to do the work, just like it was yours. This quest that you've been on is similar to a description that Charles Dickens had about a day in March in Great Expectations. That on that day in March, when you're in the shade, it is winter, and when you're in the sun, it is spring. We have spent what felt like 14 months in winter. But I want you, as you go through all your other quests throughout your career, to think about the shade, because what you've accomplished so much in the shade, you must embrace those challenges. Congratulations, good luck, and like me, you'll always bleed Jersey blue. Thank you.
Graduates, you did it. You reached the end of the tunnel. You climbed the mountain. You reached for the stars. Whatever metaphor that can be used to acknowledge your achievement this day in May of 2021, will forever be carved in the memory bank. Congratulations to you, and a heartfelt thank you to your support team, family members, friends, neighbors, who helped you make this moment possible. But I do hope what is not lost in the excitement of the day is your Brookdale journey that brought you here today's commencement. I truly, truly hope that your journey has been filled with challenges, discoveries, lifelong friends, successes, and even the occasional stubbing of your toe, all of which will be the basis of continued success as you close your Brookdale chapter and begin writing the next in your book of life. Today, you bid farewell to alma mater. I invite you to join me to continue your Brookdale experience by opening up a new chapter, reconnecting with Brookdale, engaging with other grads, involvement with faculty, and supporting students as an active member of the Brookdale Alumni Association. Remember, wherever you go, whatever you do, you are Jersey blue forever. Thank you.
Thank you, Grand Marshal Jack Ryan and Grand Marshal Bruce Marich. Each year, the graduating class elects a student to serve on the Board of Trustees as graduate trustee. Please join me in welcoming Hannah Walker, graduate trustee for 2020-2021.
Each year, a student is elected by the graduating class to serve on the Board of Trustees. The primary goal of the graduate student trustee is to be a voice of the students. Last year, the outgoing trustee, Lauren Deinhart, presented me with a journal filled with thoughts and advice from the previous graduate trustee's years of service. As I leave office, I will do the same. Today, I am presenting the Triangle Award to my successor, Austin Smith. The term triangle honors our history, a triangle of land, and the progression from student to graduate to student trustee. Please join me in congratulating Austin Smith with the 2021 to 2022 Triangle Award.
On behalf of the Board of Trustees, I'd like to welcome Austin to the board for the 2021 school year and thank Ms. Walker for her service during the preceding year. It was an extraordinary year in which the board met exclusively by Zoom. As a matter of fact, we met for the first time at the graduation ceremonies. And she did an extraordinary job of not only staying in touch with the students, but sharing with the board their concerns and in some cases their accolades for the work that the board was doing. So we appreciate your service and the valuable role that you played, Hannah.
I now ask graduating student Rose Adu to come to the podium to share some remarks with her fellow graduates. Rose has not only been an outstanding scholar, but a true leader on campus at Brookdale. As president of the Student Life Board, Rose ensured that opportunities to get involved in extracurricular activities continued virtually and in person. She was also active with our EOF program and our EOF Honor Society. Rose, thank you for your leadership and for making a difference in the lives of your peers. Please join me in welcoming Rose Adu.
Thank you, President Stout, for your kind words and support. Good afternoon, family, friends, Brookdale faculty and staff, and fellow graduates. My name is Rose Adu, and I am thrilled and deeply honored to share this excitement of this wonderful day with you in this very special place. Today, we celebrate us. I stand before you filled with a great sense of happiness and pride for time, dedication, and effort that we've put into our education to get here today. As I am sure the majority of you can agree, this journey has not always been easy. There were times where we were unsure of our path, but we've overcome adversity and struggle, not to mention this unprecedented virtual remote year. And we have excelled in our successes despite the speed bumps. For instance, if I may, my own start down the path of higher education was one of uncertainty. After graduating from high school, I knew I wanted to pursue a college education. However, finances were a major concern, and I didn't know how I was going to afford my education. My mother had worked very hard to maintain a roof over our heads and keep food on the table for my siblings and I our whole lives. For that, I am grateful. However, I did not want to burden my family with yet another cost. I did apply for financial aid, but it wasn't quite enough to cover my educational expenses to the extent necessary for me to chase my college EA dream. I almost gave up due to the overwhelming cost. Then Brookdale Community College came along. When I applied to Brookdale and discovered the Educational Opportunity Fund program, I learned that with it, I could make my college dream a reality. I was overfilled with joy. Suddenly, a college education was tangible, and I could envision my future. With all the assistance that I received from the EOS staff and my student success coach over the time at the college, I have been able to reach my educational goals and much more. Through the rigorous academics in the paralegal studies program and my extracurricular involvement through student-like activities, I can confidently say that every faculty and staff member that I've met at Brookdale has made a major positive impact on my life. With the support of the college community, I have been able to excel in all of my studies and beyond. I currently serve as the president of Brookdale Community College Student Life Board, and I am very involved in a number of other wonderful student clubs and organizations at the college. The connections that I have made, and not to mention maintained, during this virtual remote year in these organizations with other students and advisors has helped to shape me into the confident leader that I am today. At Brookdale, I have learned that I can truly can do anything I put my mind to, and that no matter how big the dream, the college is always there to help me succeed. After graduating from Brookdale, I am proud to say that I will be continuing my education at Rutgers University, studying labor studies and employment relations. I'm excited to continue to chase my dream and passion for education and legal studies that began here at Brookdale. It is times like this where I fully come to realize that the struggles and speed bumps that we've made to experience along our journey has made this moment even sweeter. Before I leave you today, I do want to take the moment to acknowledge and thank my mom, aunt, sister, brother, and my church family for all their encouragement and faith in me over the years. I also want to thank the tremendous faculty and staff at Brookdale, from the EOF office to student life and activities to Dr. Stout and beyond, for all their dedication and time they took with me to make sure I succeeded in my education. I am so grateful to have seen my dream of college education come to life, to share this time with you, and to know that we, as Brookdale Community College graduates, not only strive to be the best we can, but to leave things better than the way we found them. Thank you, and congratulations to the class of 2021.
Thank you, Rose. The Outstanding Student Awards were created in 1980 to recognize outstanding student academic achievement, community service, and personal accomplishments. Students are selected by the faculty from their respective institutes and have proven themselves to be distinguished students. Congratulations to this year's award winners. They include outstanding students in business and social science, Susanna Falls and Adam Meliani, outstanding students in humanities, Cecilia Alcantar and Bryce McLeod Fagel, outstanding students in health science, Michael Ketchertryan and Erica Villani, and outstanding students in STEM, Robert Manella and Nora Thompson. These extraordinary students have each been a vital part of our college community. Susanna Falls, a psychology major, was very active in the Phi Theta Kappa Honor Society. She said about her time with PTK, "I really thrived in this position and enjoyed working with fellow students to make Brookdale and our community a better place." Dr. Mary Beth Boylan, professor in the psychology department, said, "Susanna exemplifies the very best of our student body in all aspects, and we will not forget that she got her start at Brookdale." Susanna finished her associate's degree in the fall and is currently studying at the Brookdale-Rutgers University Partnership here on our main campus. Congratulations, Susanna. Adam Meliani worked to enhance the lives of his peers while at Brookdale. He organized and ran a financial literacy presentation with the PTK Honor Society to spread financial knowledge to his fellow students. He was also active in the National Society of Leadership and Success. "I did not know what I was capable of before attending Brookdale," Adam said. In support of this honor, Debbie Meyer, professor of economics, said, Adam impresses me immensely as an outstanding individual with a strong character, positive attitude, depth of knowledge, and a kind heart. Adam plans to transfer to a four-year university in the fall to continue his studies in finance. Congratulations, Adam. Michael Ketchatryan is a nursing major and a member of the PTK Honor Society, the Alpha Delta Nu Nursing Honor Society, and the National Society of Leadership and Success. Michael was always going the extra mile to excel in his studies and in rendering safe, effective patient care, said Christine Hogan, assistant professor in the nursing department. Most importantly, Michael consistently showed compassion and empathy to his patients and support to his classmates. Congratulations, Michael. Erica Villani is a nursing major, served on the executive board of the Nursing Association, was a part of the Alpha Delta Nu Nursing Honor Society, and the Phi Theta Kappa Honor Society. This past year has been hard for all nursing students during the COVID-19 pandemic, said Ashley Albro, adjunct in the nursing department. However, Erica came in prepared every week to learn the most she could and care for the patients the best way possible. She never let the circumstances of the past year affect her future as a student nurse or her attitude toward patients. Erica said she chose Brookdale because of the stellar reputation of the nursing program. There are tons of resources available. Faculty, academic advisors, librarians, counselors, tutors, and especially other students. Erica is going to take the NCLEX exam and hopes to be accepted into an RN residency program at one of the local hospitals. Congratulations, Erica. Cecilia Alcantar. Cecilia moved back to the United States after living in Mexico for 10 years. She came back to attend Brookdale. Taking classes in a language I did not grow up speaking is a very difficult, very hard challenge. And I hope that this inspires students, not only at Brookdale, but in other colleges or educational levels, to never give up. Cecilia was instrumental in creating the student-to-student program, where student mentors help their fellow students who are struggling to adapt virtually or making the transition to college. Cecilia's commitment to her college and community makes her a standout among her peers, Angela Saragusa, English professor and PTK advisor, said. In the fall, Cecilia is transferring to Montclair State University to study TV production. Congratulations, Cecilia. Bryce McLeod Fagel enrolled in Brookdale after a gap in his education. Brookdale is an extraordinary asset to the community and a wonderful avenue through which to return to higher education, he said. Bryce was an asset to Brookdale as he was the vice president and editor of our literary magazine, The Collage. Responsible, charismatic, thoughtful, and an independent thinker, Bryce is not only truly adept at academics, but has the talent to work and share with others in a way that seems effortless, said Roseanne Alvarez, English professor at Brookdale. Bryce plans to transfer to a four-year university to pursue his bachelor's degree in the fall. Congratulations, Bryce. Robert Minella has become an integral part of the Brookdale community and has contributed so much on so many levels. An environmental science major, Robert was involved in the Environmental Club, Phi Theta Kappa Honor Society, Math Club, the Innovation Network, Students for Global Citizenship, Global Citizenship's Distinction, Women in Engineering, Science, and Technology, the Biology Club, Physics and Astronomy Club, Engineering Students Association, and Student Veterans of America. He also completed a NASA fellowship where he completed a research project with the New York, New Jersey Baykeeper Association. After serving his country in the United States Air Force, Robert helped his fellow veterans at Brookdale by developing the Lunch with a Veteran program to encourage interaction among students and student veterans. Nothing I have ever done was for recognition. It was always for the cause, Robert said. He recently moved to Florida, where he plans on pursuing a bachelor's degree in environmental engineering. Congratulations, Robert. Nora Thompson said she fell in love with Brookdale when she was 16 and came to the main campus to take the GED exam. She has accomplished so much since that time, including completing a NASA fellowship this year, where she researched Alzheimer's disease. She's graduating with full honors as a member of the Biology Club and the Phi Theta Kappa Honor Society. Brookdale is a very supportive community of scholars, and I feel very honored and grateful to receive this award, she said. Nora is a tireless worker who never stops until she understands. She's a conscientious young woman and is genuinely curious and interested in her coursework, said James Crowder, biology professor. Nora is going to continue her education and hopes to one day go to graduate school. Her ultimate goal is to contribute to the research of Alzheimer's and to help find a cure. Congratulations, Nora. We are pleased this year to confer an honorary associate's degree in letters to Chaz Salvatore Bono. Chaz is an actor and an activist, as well as an author. He is best known for his work on American Horror Story and Curb Your Enthusiasm. Chaz has a rich history of advocating for LGBTQ rights. Having worked for two national LGBTQ organizations and speaking on college campuses and at events around the world, he continues to be a strong voice for the LGBTQ community and is a passionate champion of equality for all Americans, especially those discriminated against and targeted because of their race, religion, sex, age, ethnicity, sexual orientation, and gender identity. Thank you, Chaz, and congratulations. Each year at commencement, we acknowledge successful Brookdale graduates. We are pleased today to honor Christina and Barton Henderson. Christina is a graduate of the class of 2014 and the 2020 Mrs. New Jersey. She, along with her husband, Bart, are the owners of Henderson Promos LLC, which offers thousands of promotional products and apparel. To help do their part during the COVID-19 pandemic, Christina and Bart donated over 100,000 masks to food banks and other nonprofit organizations to help keep employees, volunteers, and the community safe. Christina also volunteers with the Giving Back Forum, Fulfill Food Bank, Tigger House Foundation, Applaud Our Kids Foundation, and more. These Brookdale alumni are shining examples of giving back to their community. Congratulations, Christina and Bart.
We're both honored to be a part of such an important day. Moving forward, avoid saying that you got or received your degree from Brookdale. You worked for this. Today, you earned your degree.
Our Brookdale journey, like many of yours, illustrates that virtually nothing worth having comes easy. Bart and I both had to pay for our own education.
While I was at Brookdale, I can remember working 70 or 80 hours a week as a bartender, coming, leaving my shift to go to classes at Brookdale, and then at night returning to work to finish out the shift. Christina did something similar. She was a bartender, a server, a waitress, a hostess, and we both did whatever we had to do to pay for our education. And because Brookdale was affordable, we were able to work and pay for our education.
Take this degree as a resolve that you can put your mind to something, work hard, and achieve it. When you are facing a challenge in work or life, think back to this moment, a time when you committed to something and finished it.
It wasn't that long ago that Christina and I were working late nights to pay for Brookdale. Since then, Christina has gone on to graduate from Boston University. She's become Mrs. New Jersey, the owner and CEO of Henderson Promos, and a philanthropist in our community. She's someone who supports other women in business and nonprofits in New Jersey.
After leaving Brookdale, Bart graduated with the highest honors and a double major from the University of Hawaii. He then got his MBA and then went on to get his law degree at the University of Massachusetts School of Law. All this from someone who, when he was in Brookdale, did not feel he was academically gifted. He is a prosperous entrepreneur and currently owns multiple successful companies, including an artificial intelligence landscaping company, a marketing company, a vacation real estate company, and he is constantly giving back to the community through his nonprofit work.
We don't usually talk about our accomplishments, but it wasn't that long ago that we were in your shoes. We were really excited for what the world had ahead of us, and frankly, we were really worried and anxious about whether or not we could live up to our goals and live up to the dreams that we had for ourselves. So we really wanted to talk about this to let all of you know that you can do anything you put your mind to.
Thank you to Brookdale, to the professors, the adjunct professors, the counselors, the staff, to our fellow alumni like Lauren Concur, and the leadership, including David Stout. To the graduates, set yourself up for happiness and success.
Don't doubt yourself and work harder than others.
Take risks, be bold, and do things that push yourself out of your comfort zone.
Don't be afraid to fail, and make it your mission to always help those around you.
Engage in the community around you, and the world will pay you back tenfold. We are honored and thankful for the opportunities Brookdale has created for us. Thank you so much.
Dr. Cram, please step to the podium to say a few words. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Stout. It's my privilege as chair of the Board of Trustees to welcome you and to offer congratulations to the class of 2021 on behalf of my fellow trustees. At each public board meeting, we open with a reading of the college's mission. At its core, our mission is to provide quality and affordable educational opportunities, to provide a pathway to careers and lifelong learning, and to ensure your success. These ideals hold a personal meaning to me. Like some of you, I was the first person in my family to go to college. Like many of you, the cost of college was an issue. And if the truth be told, like a few of you, I wasn't the greatest high school student. There was no Brookdale Community College. But I was lucky enough to attend one of New Jersey's state colleges, Patterson State, now William Patterson University, where I earned my first degree, sent recruiters to my high school. At the time, they were transitioning from a teacher's college to a broader institution. The enrollment was 7-1 women to men, which got my attention. Tuition was $75 a semester, not a credit, and they were offering open enrollment. That opportunity changed my life and offered a career path that led to my speaking to you today. It opened my mind, broadened my worldview, helped me find a career. I thought I wanted to be an engineer, but my physics and calculus teachers didn't agree, and made the life I am living possible. I will forever be indebted to Patterson State for opening all those doors. I hope that your experience at Brookdale will be as important to you. Whether you came here to become college ready or acclimate to your new country, whether you came to discover a career or prepare for the one you've selected, whether you are changing careers or seeking a bachelor's degree and beyond, I hope that your experience here and what you have learned will provide you with the continuous growth, financial stability, and the satisfying personal life that each of you deserves. And always remember, here is what got you there. Congratulations.
Dr. Reed, please step forward for conferral of the degrees.
Dr. Stout, on behalf of the faculty and staff of Brookdale Community College, I present the class of 2021 and certify that they have met all of the requirements for their appropriate degrees and respectfully submit that such be conferred upon them.
By the power vested in me by the state of New Jersey and a board of trustees at Brookdale Community College, I confer upon you the degrees as recommended.
Kelly Orbeli. Mustafa Killick. Karen Okachuku. Kaylee Vieira. Kyla Myers. Julia Lamandola. Carla Ortega Carcule.
Michelle Bonacore.
Matthew Colosavari.
Letitia Grant. Michael Guinan. Maeve McGuire.
Matthew Walters.
Congratulations, Matthew.
Matthew Johans. Elena King. Maraid Malesko. Michelle Perez. Gabriella Gotchman. Layla Reyna.
Leanne Johnson. Michael Torres. Markella Sartzitakis. Nancy Freeman. Sophia Abadi. Olivia Villalona. Michael Kachatryan, Outstanding Student in Health Sciences.
Nicole Sacco. Philip Nadrich. Philip Alanya. Oswaldo Gress. All right, Patrick H. Sullivan. Galermi Boaventura. Randy Knopf.
Philip Dryam. Raquel Morales. Niles Glover. Samantha Cavallaro. Rachel Van Driel. Scott Chenoweth. Samuel Nieves.
Taylor Basile. Tara Bradley. Sarah Getachew. Savannah Lopez. Shannon Clem. Sydney Erin Fernandez. Student Life Board President, Rose Adu. Simra Balal. Stephanie Pickenich. Tara Howell. Trinette Fox. Thomas Paluzzi. Valerie Velke. Vito Iacobello. Tyler Palladino. Thomas DeLuca. Arnold Dalla Conag. Victoria Hulse. Tony Gray. Emily Doan. Zachary Ruiz. Maham Abid. Nicole Logren.
Our new graduate trustee, Austin Smith.
Dr. Stout and Board Chair Cram, I present the graduates for the degrees of Associate in Arts, Associate in Applied Science, Associate in Science, Associate in Fine Arts, and Certificates. Graduates, you may now move your tassels from right to left. Congratulations.
Graduates, let me conclude by extending congratulations from the entire Brookdale College community to you for navigating through difficult times, overcoming extraordinary obstacles, and achieving your goals. I commend you again for your focus, your determination, and your resilience while balancing so many responsibilities and unknowns in your lives. Now, as Brookdale alumni, remember that you are part of an enormous Brookdale family. As you take your next steps, whether in your career or in one of our university partners, don't forget to tell everyone that your success started at Brookdale. We wish you the best in all of your future endeavors because we thrive on your success. Don't forget to stay connected with us, join the Alumni Association, come back and visit us. We only ask that you pay it forward by being the best ambassadors for Brookdale Community College that you can possibly be. Members of the class of 2021, congratulations. We are proud of you.